Hello! Now, I'm happy. I'm sad because this is my last Sacre Brew. Purchased on an impulse when I was in Birmingham. Was visiting many bottle shops that they are in Birmingham. Pardon me. With Harry Meadows. We was at one bottle shop, Sturgis Wines. And every one of the beers sounded awesome, and I've been following them on Facebook recently, and the recent brews sound impressive as well. Now, this was one that I picked up straight away. I had the other two beers already that I purchased from this brewery via Sturgis Wines, but this one I've always been fascinated with. Now, when I went visited Missouri, there was a Storm beer that had a mint chocolate beer, and they just sold out as I got there. I'm like, no! And everyone else tries to either make a mint chocolate stout or a orange chocolate stout. So, now this doesn't have chocolate in it, it's got the malts and stuff like that inspires the flavors of chocolate. But, yeah. Here is the Crème de Stout. Now, a stout, which is what is there, is a short-tailed weasel with a little black tail. Now, there's the price, $2.25, which is a good bit price for a craft beer. They are very impressive on the marketing on their Facebook. Everybody should do. They should market their beers really well. Sacre Brew do well. Colour on this is a dark ruby. Off chocolatey head. Initial smell, a little bit licorice, a little bit aniseed. You do get a hint of mint, almost like the mint wafers, not as potent as the after eights, it's very subtle, the mint. Definitely a little bit aniseed, but a little bit of black licorice, almost like, I don't know if you ever had it, the laces, the black licorice laces, and you can also get the red licorice laces. Now, I would compare it more to the red licorice. But anyway, cheers. First, on the palate, it's very subtle. You get a little bit of like a oaty but chocolatey flavour. The mint is like a thin body, but its texture is really dense. The mint is very soft, like Viscounts. It's almost like a chocolate digestive. Which I mentioned earlier on, a beer that I had earlier, when you put spice into a beer, you want it transitional, and when you want any addition to the beer, like mint or rhubarb or stuff like that, you want it transitional or to make the beer more pleasant on the palate. And this does. The mint is not overpowering, it's in phases. Now, this is a sweet stout, also known as a milk stout. But the labelling was done pretty poor. Whoever labelled the beer. But there you go. I definitely recommend the brewery because not only because of their uniqueness, but they're willing to step out of the boundaries and deliver great beers with unique character. Check out Station Wines, check out Sacre Brew. You take care. Goodbye.